I want to tell you one quick story. When we left Thursday night, we went out to Hawaiian Falls. We just rented it out. And so if you came to Vacation Bible School, it was a great time out there. But part of what we did is because we know every year so many kids pray to receive Christ, we hold a baptism out at Hawaiian Falls. And now part of our plan is always before you can be baptized after salvation, we have a one-way class that we want to take you through and make sure you understand salvation and you understand baptism. And you understand what the Lord's Supper is. And you understand, hey, how do I grow spiritually? It's not over just because I've gotten saved. Certainly that brings forgiveness and eternal life. But it's not over. I want to grow spiritually the rest of my life. And baptism is like putting on the jersey. And so here's what happens. So we go out. We're at Hawaiian Falls Thursday night. And there, Dave is doing the one-way class. And you have all these kids and the moms and dads sitting around just locked in. And unbeknownst to us, there was somebody else locked in. And so as we broke and go over and get ready, they've shut down that lazy river. How many of you know what the lazy river is? So they've shut down lazy river, and we baptized right in the lazy river right there. And as we're lining up, all of a sudden, the manager, the big dog of all the lifeguards, comes over. And he says, hey, I have one of my lifeguards who wants to be baptized with y'all. Give God a hand. And he says, can we do that? And I go, well, send him over here and let me talk to him. And so he comes over, and this strapping stud of a young dude in his lifeguard jersey, I walked up. He goes, I won't tell you all the whole story. He says, I was saved as a kid with my grandfather, and we kind of went to church off and on, but I know I was saved, but I've never been baptized. And I was just kind of listening to what was going on over there and kind of says, I'm ready to put on the jersey. And I'm ready to put. So I sat there and said, man, it was clear to me it had faith. But, you know, part of the desire is always to make sure that someone who goes through our baptistry really knows what it means to be saved, that it's not salvation. It's not that. So not only did I get a chance to talk to him, but I said, here's what you're going to do. We had already lined all the kids up and all the people that were going to be baptized up. I said, I want you to go stand in the back of the line. And then I called one of our interns, the husband of one of our ladies that works in children's ministry. I said, listen, y'all have got about 20 minutes before he gets to the front of the line. And he goes, I want you to be sure, make sure that he's sure of his salvation before we baptize him, because the last thing we want to do. So they roll through. They get all the way up to the front of the line with him. They're standing one on each side, and they both go, he's ready, man. And so I bring him down in the water, and so you got all the lifeguards standing around. He's in his lifeguard uniform. They're all standing around looking at him, and he is right here saying, identify me with Christ. And so I ask him to announce his name, and all of our people, they're standing there, give him a hand, and it was clapping, it was awesome. And then I said, hey, what do you do? And he goes, I'm a wrestler. And I'm thinking, yeah, you look like a wrestler. And I'm thinking, I hope this doesn't go bad, because I don't think I could win this fight, okay? And he says, man, I go to the Colony High School, and I'm 17 years old. And he goes, I want to today publicly identify with Jesus Christ. And so that's the impact that you're having both inside the walls and outside the walls. So give God a hand for that. And that was a neat story.